Quality of competition may have been the hallmark of the 2020 Quincy City Tournament, but Championship Sunday opened with the Bergtorf Blitzkrieg taking place in the Women's Championship Flight. Crystal Bergtorf opened the day with a three-stroke lead, and here on the par 3 fourth, she drained this luscious downhill 30-footer with fantastic touch for birdie to widen the margin to 6. That was an incredibly difficult putt, more fun to come on the next hole, as Crystal picked up 3 more strokes with this up-and-down birdie on number 5, all part of a blistering 72 on the day. That would give her a 10-stroke victory and her first women's city title on the heels of 2 days of outstanding play.
I felt pretty good about the way I played yesterday and today together. I didn't really know what I was gonna do when I first came into it, but it ended up pretty well, and I think that had a lot to do with who I was playing with, and they didn't really get down on themselves, and they had a good positive attitude as well.
We had much more spirited action on the men's side, starting with Gary Anders firing 74 today to complete the comeback and win the first flight with a 145 for his 2-day total. Championship flight contenders outside the top 4 also making marks today. Good week for Aaron Neff, back in town from Texas, 1-under-70 today to finish tied for 6th. TJ Wensing doing his work, former Quincy Blue Devil, hits the stick on one. He'd end up with a birdie right here. 72-78 was his 2-day total. Brad Niemann off to a great start. Hole number 1 with the birdie right here, 143 for 2 days. He finished tied for 9th. Ryan Buxman doing some work on number 1 as well, draining the long putt. He would finish 11th overall. But as expected, our top foursome would produce our ultimate champion. First round co-leader Ryan Shankey right here with the birdie on number 2, while the guy he shared the clubhouse lead with, Alex McCullough, opened his day bogey-bogey. Sensing opportunity, Ryan goes back to work. Look at the approach on 5 right here, his second shot to set up an eagle attempt. He'd ultimately settle for birdie. Meanwhile, Adam Pfeiffer, 7-time city champion, lurking an eagle putt of his own. Just a bit short, he'd take the birdie right there, trying to track down Shankey. Blaise Haxel gets into the act and gets really hot on number 7 right here. Magnificent approach right there, and then he would bang that home for a birdie. He would fire 72 on the day. Shankey up 2 after the front 9 and after that great Haxel move. But the moves would continue for the guys trailing him. It's Adam Pfeiffer yet again on number 10 to give himself a chance right here at a birdie on number 10. Meanwhile, Blaise Haxel, who drove the green on number 10, drops the birdie putt here as well. Disaster for Shankey coming on number 12 right here. He would end up having to settle for a 6 after hitting a ball into the hazard and not making the bogey putt right there. The door is open for whoever wants to take it. At this point, Pfeiffer up 2, but Alex McCullough wakes back up. Your defending champ on number 13 gives himself a birdie opportunity. Shankey, meanwhile, down 2 at this point, would get back to within 1 thanks to this absolutely magnificent curling downhill putt on number 13 to close the back within a stroke. McCullough, the birdie binge continues with another one on 14, but Pfeiffer just will not relinquish on 17, going 190 over the trees for his second shot to give himself an eagle putt right here. Leaves it just short, tap in birdie. The lead is too substantial to overcome going into 18 at that point. A nifty approach to give himself a shot at birdie and an easy par. McCullough finishing well today with a 71, and the birdie to finish it right there on the drop with a 138, 2 strokes off the pace. In similar fashion, Ryan Shankey, also a defending former champion in this one, a 71 today, a birdie to finish, and a 138. But it is Adam Pfeiffer moving his name next to the legendary Mike O'Connell with 8 city championships, cleaning up the day with the par putt right there to finish his second straight 68, the only golfer in the field to go red numbers both days, and proving why he's just so good on this course, just so good on this format.
Well, I'm extremely humbled. I mean, to be a part of so many unbelievable names that have played in this tournament. You got PGA professionals, you got people that are gonna be playing Division I college golf. Obviously, 8 is great, and it's never easy. It always goes to the last hole, and it's just an unbelievable feeling. I can't tell you how humbling it is to be a part of so many great names out here. There's so many unbelievable good players. I think this is one of the best fields that we've had in maybe a decade. So to have so many good players in it, my brother in it, obviously the last 4 of us were neck and neck with just a few holes left. So it's obviously the kind of patience prevails sometimes, and it seems like everybody kind of comes back to the pack for the most part, but sometimes you just have to be patient and take what the course gives you, and I did that today and was fortunate enough to win.